Hare Krishna. This story is about an extraordinary incident that occurred around 500 years ago. This is a story of Haridas Thakur, who used to chant the Hare Krishna Maha Mantra for 22 hours every day. Local, envious people even sent a professional prostitute once to defame him. But in turn, she too became a great devotee and started chanting Hare Krishna Maha Mantra daily for 22 hours. Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu once inquired from Haridas Thakur, who was known as Brahma Haridas, how the Yavans or persons bereft of Vedic culture would be delivered in Kalyug. Haridas Thakur replied that their deliverance would be possible if they very loudly chanted the Hare Krishna mantra. For hearing the Hare Krishna mantra chanted out loudly, even with little realization, would help them. After describing this incident, the author of the Chaitanya Charitamrita also describes how Haridas Thakur was tested at Benapol, a village near Shantipur. A person named Ramchandra Khan, who was envious of Haridas Thakur, sent a professional prostitute to attempt to defame him. But by the mercy of Haridas Thakur, even the prostitute was delivered. Because of offending a pure Vaishnav, Ramchandra Khan was later cursed by Nityanand Prabhu and ruined. From Benapol, Haridas Thakur went to the village known as Chandpur, where he lived at the house of Balram Acharya. Thereafter, Haridas Thakur was received by two brothers known as Hiranya and Govardhan Majumdar. But in the course of a discussion, he was offended by a caste Brahmin known as Gopal Chakravarti. Because of this offense, Gopal Chakravarti was punished by being afflicted with leprosy. Haridas Thakur later left Chandpur and went to the house of Advaita Acharya, where he was tested by Maya Devi, the personification of the external energy. She also received his favor by being blessed with the chanting of the Hare Krishna Maha Mantra. After leaving his home, Haridas Thakur stayed for some time in the forest of Benapol. Haridas Thakur would chant the holy name of the Lord 3 lakh times daily. He chanted throughout the entire day and night. For his bodily maintenance, he would go to a Brahmin's house and beg some food. He was spiritually so influential that all the neighboring people worshipped him. A landholder named Ramchandra Khan was the zamindar of that district. He was envious of Vaishnavs and was therefore a great atheist, unable to tolerate that such respect was being offered to Haridas Thakur. Ramchandra Khan planned in various ways to dishonor him. By no means could he find any fault in the character of Haridas Thakur. Therefore, he called for local prostitutes and began a plan to discredit His Holiness. Ramchandra Khan said to the prostitutes, "There is a mendicant named Haridas Thakur. All of you devise a way to deviate him from his vows of austerity." Among the prostitutes, one attractive girl was selected. "I shall attract the mind of Haridas Thakur within 3 days," she promised. Ramchandra Khan said to the prostitute, "My constable will go with you, so that as soon as he sees you with Haridas Thakur, immediately he will arrest him and bring both of you to me." The prostitute replied, "First let me have union with him once. Then the second time I shall take your constable with me to arrest him." At night, the prostitute, after dressing herself most attractively, went to the cottage of Haridas Thakur with great jubilation. After offering obeisances to the tulsi plant, she went to the door of Haridas Thakur, offered him obeisances and stood there. Exposing part of her body to his view, she sat down on the threshold of the door and spoke to him in very sweet words. "My dear Thakur, O great preacher, great devotee, you are so beautifully built and your youth is just beginning. Who is the woman who could control her mind after seeing you? I am eager to be united with you. My mind is greedy for this. if I don't obtain you, I shall not be able to keep my body and soul together." Haridas Thakur replied, "I shall accept you without fail, but you will have to wait until I have finished chanting my regular rounds on my beads. Until that time, please sit and listen to the chanting of the holy name. As soon as I am finished, I shall fulfill your desire." Hearing this, the prostitute remained sitting there while Haridas Thakur chanted on the beads until the light of morning appeared. When she saw that it was morning, the prostitute stood up and left. Coming before Ramchandra Khan, she informed him of all the news. "Today Haridas Thakur has promised to enjoy with me. Tomorrow, certainly I shall have union with him." The next night, when the prostitute came again, Haridas Thakur gave her many assurances. "Last night you were disappointed. Please excuse my offense. I shall certainly accept you. Please sit down and hear the chanting of the Hare Krishna Maha Mantra until my regular chanting is finished. Then your desire will surely be fulfilled." After offering her obeisances to the tulsi plant and Haridas Thakur, she sat down at the door. Hearing Haridas Thakur chanting the Hare Krishna mantra, she also chanted, "O my Lord Hari, O my Lord Hari." When the night came to an end, the prostitute was restless. Seeing this, Haridas Thakur spoke to her as follows, "I have vowed to chant 10 million names in a month. I have taken this vow, but now it is nearing its end. I thought that today I would be able to finish my performance of Yajna, my chanting of the Hare Krishna mantra. I tried my best to chant the holy name all night, but I still did not finish. Tomorrow I will surely finish and my vow will be fulfilled. Then it will be possible for me to enjoy with you in full freedom." The prostitute returned to Ramchandra Khan and informed him of what had happened. The next day she came earlier, at the beginning of the evening, and stayed with Haridas Thakur. After offering obeisances to the tulsi plant and Haridas Thakur, she sat down on the threshold of the room. Thus, she began to hear Haridas Thakur's chanting and she also personally chanted, "Hari Hari, the holy name of the Lord. Today it will be possible for me to finish my chanting," Haridas Thakur informed her. "Then I shall satisfy all your desires." The night ended while Haridas Thakur was chanting. But by his association, the mind of the prostitute had changed. The prostitute, now purified, fell at the lotus feet of Haridas Thakur and confessed that Ramchandra Khan had appointed her to pollute him. She said, "Because I have taken the profession of a prostitute, I have performed unlimited sinful acts. My Lord, be merciful to me. Deliver my fallen soul." Haridas Thakur replied, "I know everything about the conspiracy of Ramchandra Khan. He is nothing but an ignorant fool. Therefore, his activities do not make me feel unhappy. On the very day Ramchandra Khan was planning his intrigue against me, I would have left this place immediately. But because you came to me, I stayed here for 3 days to deliver you." The prostitute said, "Kindly act as my spiritual master. Instruct me in my duty by which I can get relief from material existence." Haridas Thakur replied, "Immediately go home and distribute to the Brahmins whatever property you have. Then come back to this room and stay here forever in Krishna consciousness. Chant the Hare Krishna mantra continuously and render service to the tulsi plant by watering her and offering prayers to her. In this way, you will very soon get the opportunity to be sheltered at the lotus feet of Krishna." After thus instructing the prostitute about the process of chanting the Hare Krishna mantra, Haridas Thakur stood up and left, continuously chanting, "Hari Hari." Thereafter, the prostitute distributed to the Brahmins whatever household possessions she had, following the order of her spiritual master. The prostitute shaved her head clean in accordance with Vaishnav principles and stayed in that room wearing only one cloth. Following in the footsteps of her spiritual master, she began chanting the holy name of Krishna 3 lakh times a day. she chanted throughout the entire day and night. She worshipped the tulsi plant, following in the footsteps of her spiritual master. Instead of eating regularly, she chewed whatever food she received as alms, and if nothing was supplied, she would fast. Thus, by eating frugally and fasting, she conquered her senses. And as soon as her senses were controlled, symptoms of love of Godhead appeared in her person. Thus, the prostitute became a celebrated devotee. She became very advanced in spiritual life, and many stalwart Vaishnavs would come to see her. Seeing the sublime character of the prostitute, everyone was astonished. Everyone glorified the influence of Haridas Thakur and offered him obeisances. By inducing a prostitute to disturb Haridas Thakur, Ramchandra Khan caused a seed of offense at his lotus feet to germinate. This seed later became a tree, and when it fructified, Ramchandra Khan ate its fruits. Hare Krishna.